Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. So today I'm going to be doing a makeup tutorial for you guys on this look that I'm wearing right now, which I created using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette. So I wore this look out yesterday to lunch and like left it on until I went to bed pretty much. So I thought I would recreate this look for you guys today. I have to say I was super impressed with this palette. Like, the pigmentation is amazing, the colours are beautiful. They blend really easy. I've only used a few of the colours out of it so far, but I can't wait to do more looks with this palette for you guys, because I was super impressed. So just want to say a quick thank you to my best friend Sophie for getting this for me, because yeah, otherwise I wouldn't know how amazing this is. So I used a few of the colours out of the palette today for this look. But I was interested in doing a palette series with this palette, so if you are interested, then please give this video a big thumbs up so I know I'm to do that for you guys, because there's so many looks you can create with this. Like, so many looks. Look at those beautiful colours. Like, I would love to use, whoops, this orange. And, you know, the bronze. There's so many beautiful colours, and it's got a little bit of everything as well. There's a couple of cool tones, but lots of warm tones, so... yeah, I'm super impressed with this palette. So that is what I used today to create this look. There was probably something I was gonna say and now I can't remember. So also, don't mind my nose today, because it is a little cracked from blowing on it, because it looks like I am sick again. And yes, I am always sick, I know that. So don't mind that throughout the video. I try my best to make it look nice. You just can't. So yeah, be aware of that throughout the video, but yeah, I'm excited to show you guys how to get this look, so if you are interested, then please stay tuned and keep on watching. Okay, so my brows are already done, just to save a bit of time, so I'm going to move on with my eyes, just because we're using some dark colours. So I'm going to start off with priming my eyelids, and I'm going to use the MAC Soft Ochre Paint Pot. And I'm just going to use that as a base. And around my, underneath my brow, I'm going to use it as well to carve the brow out and make sure it's all nice and clean. I'm going to just use my finger to finish blending. Once that's on, we're just going to go and set that, and I'm just going to jump in with the Modern Renaissance palette, which is what we're going to be using for the whole look today, and I'm going to go in with Tempera? This one here, and just lightly dust it over the whole lid. From brow to lash line. So now that that's set, we need to then go in with our crease, and I'm going to start with the colour Warm Taupe, this one here, and just on a nice big fluffy brush, I'm going to pick a little bit up and just start buffing that into the crease. Now this is going to be our transition shade. So I'm just doing like windscreen wiper motions and little circles. So next I'm going to be working on the outer half of my eye, and I'm going to start off with the colour Red Ochre, this one here. I'm just going to start pressing that into the And then I'm just going to pick up the brush we're using the brown with and just buff that into the crease. And then just go back in with the red ochre. Now don't worry if it gets too messy on the outside here. The reason we did the eyes first is we can clean it up before we do our foundation. It's not going to ruin our base or anything like that. So once that's built up to the desired intensity, so you can keep packing and blending, or you can just leave it as is. Like this, I want to go in with a little bit of Love Letter, which is this one here. I'm just going to use it on the fluffy brush I've been blending with. I'm just pick up the tiniest amount and start buffing it into the crease. Now, it doesn't make the biggest difference, so this isn't necessary, you can leave it out. But I like the sort of purpley tone it adds to the crease. So once that's all blended, I'm then going to do my inner half, and I'm going to pick up a flat shader brush, and I'm going to use the colour Primavera, which is this colour here, which is a beautiful gold colour, and I must say it's super pigmented as well. So this is how it's going to look dry, and if you want it more intense, then go in with a damp brush and pop the product on that way. So like, look how intense that is. That is super intense. Just gonna work that into the first half and overlap onto the red ochre. Put on. That looks super intense. It's not one of my favourite colours out of the palette. Okay, so then I'm going to go in with the blending brush that we've been using, no additional product, and just buff the edges of the crease, just lightly, just so it's not like a sharp line and the crease colour blends nicely. And then we're going to go in with the flat brush that we used to pack the product on and just start meshing them together. So I like to go between brushes without any extra product on. So the flat brush we use the red colour on first, just pressing over there and then there. Just so we get like a nice gradient effect and it's not like a harsh line. So now that that's done, that is pretty much our eyelids done. So then I'm going to go in with liner, and I'm going to be first of all tight lining my eyes with I'm just using the Essence Gel Eye Pencil, which is what I pretty much use in like every tutorial. And then once that one's done, I'm going to do a wing, and I'm going to use my MAC eyeliner gel. I'm going to go over it with a black eyeshadow just to intensify, because I didn't do that yesterday, but it would look really faded and look like it'd worn. So I'm going to go over it with the NYX Love in Paris, the black eyeshadow in the centre. So I'm going to work one eye at a time. So I'm just going to start on the inner corner and just do a thin line. And then work my way to the wing. Now you definitely don't need to do a wing, you can leave it as is and just put some mascara on. Or you can do a little wing, or you can just line the eye with your liner. Whatever. So once you've sort of got your like your base done, then I'm gonna go in with the eyeshadow and just an angled brush and that black from the Love in Paris palette, and just sort of go over what we've done. So I'm gonna go ahead and do the other eye quickly off camera because I'm gonna have trouble evening them out, and then we'll be back. Okay, so I've done my eyes and they are definitely not even, but I'm gonna work on because otherwise I'm gonna stuff it up even more and they are a little thicker than so now I'm just gonna clean up the eye. So just using a wipe and just any fallout and just cleaning up that edge. So that's a good way to clean up if you made any mistakes with your eyeliner. Do that. So next we're going to do the rest of the face, and we'll quickly do my foundation base and all that off camera just to speed it all up. You should have seen me do that a million times. Oh wait, I should probably do my eyelash mascara. I'll do my top mascara first on my top lashes. So I'm going to use the Rimmel London Lash Accelerator and just pop some of this on my top lashes. Okay, so now I'm gonna go do my face off camera and I'll be back. I've done my base, I don't mind my nose. Looks gross. And I'm ready to go back in with the under eyes. So I'm gonna go back in with the Modern Renaissance palette to do the bottom lash line as well. So I'm gonna start off with my lower lash line. I'm going to put a white pencil in my waterline. I just like to use a brush to pull down my lash line just to make sure I get no fingerprints. Now I did use black on the bottom lash line yesterday, so it's up to you what colour you'd like to use. You can even use like a ready toned colour if you would like. Now I'm really weird. Okay, so for the bottom lash line, we're going to start off with the Warm Tone shade. I'm just going to start popping that underneath the lash line. So this is going to help just the other colours blend nicely. If you want, you can just leave it like this, and then it looks nice on its own. So then I'm going to go in with the red ochre, just on that flatter rounder brush. I don't know, it is a e.l.f. professional eyeshadow brush, and then just start buffing that on the outer half of the lower lash line. And I want the lower lash line really smoky, so I'm going to really buff it out. So it's like, yeah, really smoky. This also is good if you have under eye creases that no matter how much you bake and all that, it can't get out because it like gives it that illusion. And then I'm going to take a touch of Love Letter, like we did it in the top crease, just the littlest amount, just mixed in. As I said, it's not a necessary step. And then I'm just going to I'll do my inner corner and brow bone. I'm going to use Vermeer from this palette here and pop that on my inner corners and my brow bone. And then, so this is the brush that the palette came with, so I used that end for the highlight, and then I'm going to use the other end and just buff that in with the rest, so it's like really nice and seamless. Pretty pretty. And then I'm just going to do mascara on my bottom lashes. I'm using the Rimmel Lash Accelerator as a digital. Okay, so let's go on to the rest of the face. So I'm going to bronze first. So I had a really glowy skin yesterday, but I want to just tone it down a bit today. So I'm going to use the Rimmel London Natural Bronzer, and this one's in Sun Bronze. And I'm just going to use this to really just bronze the face, not really contouring as such. I forget how much I like this bronzer, like, until I bring it back out, and then I love it, and then I put it away and forget to use it and do something else, and then bring it back out, and I'm like, oh man, I like that look all over again. So yesterday I did, when I wore this look, I did do heavy contouring, and all that, but I'm just going to do a little bit of a softer look today. I mean, it's not really that much softer because it's within an eye, but... Anyways, and then we're going to use some blush. I'm just using my Essence Matte Touch Blush, Bury Me Up. And this is a really nice, pretty, plummy tone to it, which is going to match like perfectly with the eyes because it's got the same undertones. So, let's pop that. I'm just going to put a little bit on my nose, a little bit on my forehead, like not overly the top, but my chin. And then highlight, and I'm going to go in with my Love Baked Face Shimmer, and this is the gold shade, or the gold one, so I'm here. And just really, Hannah, thanks. And just pop that everywhere. And then what I'm going to do, just to make sure it's all melded together, is grab my powder brush and just pat everything in. Just like that. Now for lips. So now for lips, I just went with a neutral shade just because I wanted to, I guess. So I used the Rimmel London Provoke Lips in shade 730 Make Your Move, and I didn't use the gloss, I just used as a matte liquid lipstick, and I just popped that on my lips. And I didn't use a liner or anything like that. And this has the same like berry undertone, so it's going to match nicely with the eyes. And And when it comes to computer butt, I just go straight across. So depending what angle you're at, depend how your lips look, and that's gonna make the top lip look a bit fuller. So you can go in with your gloss side if you wish, or you can leave it as is. And that, I think, is a final look. And that is a final look, guys. Oh. Concludes this makeup tutorial that I have created using the Anastasia Beverly Hills Modern Renaissance palette. I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to give this channel a big thumbs up video, a big thumbs up if you liked it, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel if you haven't done so already. Don't forget, if you would like to see a palette series using the Modern Renaissance palette, then please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up as well so we know, and you can also comment below what type of looks you'd like to see with this palette so we can do those for you. So thank you guys for watching. Until next time, we'll see you soon. Bye.